Logitech recently launched their productivity center and one of the most popular computer mice, the Logitech MX Master 3. The MX Master series was debuted in 2015 and the last model was the MX Master 2S, which was released over 2 years ago and had been one of the most popular mice since then. This mouse received a lot of appreciation from the popular YouTuber as it helped them maintain their workflow while working with multiple systems. We are required to complete a lot of work in our workplace on a daily basis. For a day off full of productivity and to complete our tasks more efficiently, there are a lot of accessories available for our PCs and laptops. However, when it comes to computer mice, enough companies are not making productivity-focused mice. There are mouse, keyboard, and headphones for regular use and for gamers. But there isn't a lot of option available for people who want more out of their mouses without the flashy RGB lights and insane colors or design pattern, except for the Logitech MX Master series. Logitech is dedicated into making products that are simple and durable while offering useful features that helps maintain workflow. They make simplistic computer accessories and can even be found on the Apple Store. However, not all of their products are that popular like the MX Master series. It is a popular mouse among people who want to maintain their productivity and workload. Now, why it is so popular? To answer that question and to review the new MX Master 3 from Logitech, I am Nick from TechSquare is here with you today. The MX Master 3 comes in a more compact and slimmer box. Inside the box, there is another box with the MX logo on the top, and when you flip open the box, the mouse itself is just sitting there with the Logitech unifying receiver. There is also a charging cable and user manual documentation. Other than that, there is nothing else, and it is clear that they have followed Apple's footprint in their packaging. So, good job Logitech on keeping it simple. From a physical standpoint, the MX Master 2S and 3 looks very different. The MX Master 3 doesn't have the pointed tip like the 2S, and in the 3, the palm and thumb area has been slimmed down by a little bit. Weight-wise, the MX Master 3 is also lighter by 3 to 4 grams, but you probably won't be able to tell the difference. However, since palm and thumb area has been slimmed down, you will definitely feel the ergonomics while using the mouse. On the MX Master 2S, the forward and backward buttons and the side wheel felt crammed in, which has been redone on the MX Master 3, and now they have dedicated forward and backward buttons, and the side wheel is now more easily accessible than the MX Master 2S, allowing me to reach all three of them without having to stress my thumb like I had to with the 2S. They have also shifted the battery indicator to more visible area, which previously would have hidden by my thumb. Unfortunately, the MX Master 3 is not ambidextrous, so left-hand users are out of the equation. If you prefer a palm-type grip, then the Master 3 does not disappoint. For the first time, the Master 3 uses a USB Type-C for charging, and it supports quick charge, which I think a way forward. For a minute of full charge, you can get about 3 hours of usage time. Unfortunately though, battery life hasn't improved compared to the 2S since they still feature the same size battery. So you can expect up to 70 days worth of use from a single full charge. Which is still amazing considering the fact that this is a wireless mouse packed with features. Like the 2S, the Master 3 connects via the unifying receiver or over Bluetooth and supports easy switching. Which means you can switch between 3 different systems at the same time by this button on the back. I think this is a pretty cool feature which will come in super handy when I'm working on an environment where I have to switch between different systems at the same time. This also enables users to transfer text, images, files between different computer systems, which is another cool feature that helps to maintain better workflow. Now let's talk about the speed scroll wheel of the mouse. Logitech has implemented electromagnets inside the wheel, which is supposed to offer silent and precise movement, as well as a seamless transition between ratchet mode and free spin. For those of you wondering, ratchet mode is when you can physically feel the scroll steps, whereas if you quickly switch over to free spin, you're basically letting the scroll wheels go for as long as it can, depending on how much force you have applied. On face spin mode, the wheel feels very smooth and there is no noticeable amount of sound. Master 2SS wheel produced more sound than the MX Master 3. The wheel also saw another upgrade as it is now full aluminum while the 2S had rubber on the aluminum, which attracted a lot of dust. The buttons on the MX Master 3 gives pretty great tactile feedback except for the backward and forward buttons, which feels pretty mushy. Except that everything else is over the top with the MX Master 3. The Master 3 adds extra layer of feature on top of that by pre-configuring the mouse with different app profiles. Once you install Logitech options, the app scans for programs that you have installed on your system and it identifies programs like Adobe Photoshop, Final Cut Pro, Microsoft Office, Adobe Premiere Pro, and a few more, and it loads the button layout automatically. Logitech has really unleashed customization to a whole other level, especially with that horizontal scroll wheel, as it is more intuitive to use and I really love using it for editing pictures, videos and working on MS Excel. Now, technically, MX Master 2S can do all that, except you lose a lot of tool-based support for the horizontal scroll wheel and you also miss out on the pan feature. The horizontal scroll wheel is a very useful feature for video editors to scroll through their timeline, graphics designer to easily zoom in and zoom out, and for productivity apps like Microsoft Excel. Plus, you also have to create profiles for every app by yourself since it doesn't come preloaded with any profiles. Other than that, the MX Master 3 still uses the same dark field 4000 dpi sensor just like the 2S. However, since it's not a gaming mouse, rather a productivity mouse, so that's acceptable in my opinion. Although the MX Master 3 will cost you $100, in that price range you can get a pretty great and decent gaming mouse. So why it is priced so much when it's not even a gaming mouse? All of this comes down to how great features it offers and how easily and on satisfactory level it delivers. I have Corsair Dark Core SE gaming mouse, which I use for gaming, and it is pretty decent gaming mouse. But even when using that mouse, I found it to have lag issue and connectivity issues, which I have never experienced while using the MX Master 2S for the past 2 years. And even though I have only been using the MX Master 3 for only about a week, I am pretty confident that this would deliver me that same level of standard and quality. Logitech poured a lot of resources into this and they have delivered the result in terms of features, seamless connectivity and workflow. A lot of Chinese manufacturers had tried to replicate their design and the functionalities, but they couldn't even deliver it on level where they could be a viable alternative against the Logitech MX Master series. So, in my opinion, if you want to switch from a basic mouse to a mouse that can deliver a lot and help you in terms of productivity, then switching to the MX Master 3 is going to be a very good decision. Especially if you're a content creator who is always working on video editing softwares or a professional who has to use Photoshop, MS Office apps on a regular basis. And that is why the Logitech MX Master is one of the most popular wireless mice out there. That's all for today, and if you liked the video, then hit thumbs up and share with your friends. Comment below to let us know your thoughts and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this.